Government is optimistic that the Farmers Cooperative Bank will help farmers access low-interest loans to boost growth in the agricultural sector. The development has been put to light today by the State Minister of Finance, Amos Lugolobi, during the presentations regarding how far the Minister of Finance has gone in achieving the NRM Manifesto promises of 2021-2026 to the Ugandans. According to the minister, they have started the Farmers Bank initiative with a comprehensive study, which is going to give them guidance.
Government, through the Ministry of Trade, Industry and Cooperatives, is undertaking a feasibility study to assess the viability of establishing a national bank for cooperatives. Formal jobs in the agricultural sector also registered an increase from 51,384 employees in 2021 to 57,731 employees in 2021-2022. The private sector contributed about 83% of the total formal sector jobs, with high concentration in agriculture.
He further expounded on the progress they have registered so far as the Minister of Finance in these 2 years of the manifesto.
In the financial year 2021-2022, the economy grew by 4.6%, and that was an improvement from 3.5% registered in the previous year. Over the first quarter of this financial year, the economy grew by 7.5% compared to 2.7% in the same quarter of financial year 2021. In the EAC, Uganda now enjoys a trade surplus of 15.9 million United States dollars.
Despite these achievements, Lugolobi contends that they are still challenged by the growing debt burden. Relatedly, officials from the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development also highlighted their progress in achieving the NRM manifesto premises. The State Minister for Energy, Sidronius Okasai Opolot, explained that their target is to ensure universal coverage of electricity by 2030, and this will cost government $5 billion.
Reduce the cost of power, particularly for manufacturing, to US 5 cents per kilowatt hour by 2024-2025 from US dollars 8.7 cents in 2021-2020.
Today, much emphasis is put on the affordability of electricity by manufacturers and the industries, giving hope that the cost of electricity for domestic use will continue going down once more consumption is registered. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.